Hello everyone, today I will introduce to you the movie One Piece Red. It has made a huge impact and set the box office on fire in all cinemas in 2022. Let's watch it together. In the era of pirate development, pirates have sprung up like mushrooms after the rain. While some elite pirates set sail to chase their dreams, there are still some pirates who only know how to plunder everywhere. The Marines follow the orders of the world government but often just stand by and watch. These weak people have to rely on someone for their last glimmer of hope. The only person they can count on is Yuta, an idol. People have to queue up for miles to watch Yuta's concert. On the ship, Luffy is showing off his grilling skills, and a fan like Chopper are excitedly cheering. Sanji, a big fan of Yuta, doesn't need to be mentioned. What are you jumping around like that for, you crazy guy? A swordsman like you knows nothing about music. Be careful, I might grill you too. At this point, the concert has begun. Before the bright lights, a voice rises, and Yuta appears. She uses a seductive K-pop dance, attracting everyone. A series of images appear and spread around the world, from the countryside to the city, from the plains to the mountains. People here seem to be immersed in the music. After her performance, Yuta jumps down to send her warm greetings to her fans. In the distance, an old man is always following her. At this moment, a group is plotting to kidnap Yuta. Luffy uses his elongated arm to fly down, and he says, "You're Yuta, right? Do you still remember me? Luffy, is that you?" Then Yuta and Luffy exchange an affectionate hug. People here are quite surprised that a famous singer is befriending a pirate. Luffy tells them that she's the daughter of red-haired Shanks, one of the four emperors. Suddenly, gunshots ring out as the kidnappers approach them. Brulee and Oven, Big Mom's two children, also appear. Luffy says, "Witch, what are you doing here?" "I'm not a witch," she opens a portal, and soldiers pour out from within. Sanji, Brook, and Zoro rush to confront them. Zoro and Brook use their lightning-fast techniques to defeat the soldiers. Sanji uses his leg to kick one of them away. Luffy jumps up and punches, sending dozens of soldiers flying. Yuta raises her hand to thank Luffy and everyone for their protection. But this performance is all about joy, there's no sorrow. A man threatens Yuta with a sword at her throat, but Luffy steps forward. However, Yuta stops him and uses her abilities to sing a song. A combat suit appears, and Yuta transforms into a warrior. The soldiers are all turned into balls and hang on musical notes. This stunning performance leaves everyone surprised. Yuta descends from the stage and says that today's concert will last indefinitely, and they will always be together. She addresses the Marines and the world government, warning them that if they disrupt this performance, they will pay the price. She claims to be the one opening a new era, using her singing to create happiness. Elsewhere, the five elders are watching the live stream, and they consider Yuta a threat due to her fame. They decide that they must eliminate this budding rebellion before it's too late. Meanwhile, Admiral Akainu decides to send 30 warships to destroy this performance, with Kizaru and Fujitora leading the way. Yuta transforms the musical notes into gifts for her fans. Big Mom is also watching the live stream, desiring Yuta's power. Her other children are competing to achieve feats, while Katakuri chooses to stay home and play games. On Sunny, everyone is having a great time. Robin asks Luffy if he knows Yuta's abilities, to which Luffy responds that Yuta was blessed with the power of music. Yuta suddenly appears and asks if everyone is having fun. She curiously questions Luffy, "Why do you have that hat? Have you ever wanted to have a match with me?" Luffy declines, thinking Yuta is too weak, as he won 183 matches in a row against her. Yuta mentions that they used to play a game called Chicken Leg Duel when they were young. Yuta uses her abilities to create a stage and summons a turkey behind Luffy. They are about to start their duel to see who gets knocked off first. Yuta distracts Luffy by throwing an orange, causing him to be knocked into the sea. She rescues Luffy and says, "I forgot you've eaten a devil fruit." Luffy gets angry, accusing Yuta of cheating. Yuta claims she won and asks Luffy where Shanks is. Nami then asked why the two of them knew each other. Luffy explained that Yuta came to his village with Shanks 12 years ago, and they played a game of chicken leg duel in front of Shanks. Yuta also tricked Luffy with a glass of orange juice, and Luffy accused her of cheating. He said she's not a real pirate yet. This angered Yuta, who claims she is a pirate because she has been on adventures with Shanks for many years. They decided to fight, but Shanks intervened and stopped them. Both of them followed Shanks when they were kids and didn't let go of him. However, Luffy was curious about why Yuta disappeared, and Shanks only said that she wanted to be a singer, so she left the crew to pursue a career in showbiz. Now Yuta tried to persuade Luffy to give up being a pirate and stay with her, but Luffy refused because he wanted to become the Pirate King. "I'm full now and need to take a nap," Yuta playfully said. she told everyone to enjoy the fun and happiness here forever. When Nami disagreed, Yuta knocked her and Sanji away using her powers, leaving them suspended on a musical staff. The audience on the sidelines wanted Yuta to deal with Luffy's crew, and Zoro felt something was wrong, drawing his sword. Yuta clapped her hands, creating soldiers to attack them. Yuta flew to Luffy and told him to give up being a pirate if he's her friend. Luffy refused, saying he didn't want to fight her, but she did. Yuta attacked Chopper, and with her two colored wings, she controlled the soldiers with musical notes and created threads that captured the entire group, suspending them from the musical staff. Yuta declared that she wouldn't let Luffy become the Pirate King because pirates were seen as villains by everyone. Luffy managed to break free but was hit by a fan of Yuta, splashing seawater on him and causing him to lose his powers. At that moment, Bartolomeo appeared and used his barrier to protect Luffy, and Law teleported them away. Barto asked Law if he was also a fan of Yuta. Law replied that he wasn't, but Beppo was a fan. Luffy thanked Law but stated that it wasn't the time to be laughing. They needed to find out Yuta's ability. However, Luffy said he had already defeated Yuta 184 times. Yuta had now caught up with them, so they decided to run away. Yuta started pursuing them using a car she created from her musical notes. Kobe was pretending to be a fan and wanted to call for reinforcements. Luffy was concerned about his crew, and Bartolomeo carried Luffy with him. They were in a hurry and accidentally crashed into a wall. As Yuta's soldiers were searching for them, an elderly man guided them to a hidden place. Luffy asked who the old man was, and he introduced himself as Gordon, the ruler of the Allegia Nation. This place used to be the capital of music before everyone disappeared overnight. He was the one who raised Yuta. Since there were only two of them here, the little girl was very lonely. She often sang about her lost friend. Gordon nurtured her to become a famous singer who brought joy to everyone. However, he didn't know how to make others hear her singing. Finally, that moment came 2 years ago when a Denden drifted ashore. Thanks to it, Yuta's singing was heard worldwide, and her fan base grew. When Yuta learned about the chaotic life in the outside world during the era of pirates, which was an endless battle, she decided to create her own world in return for her fans. A world of pure joy without sorrow. Gordon pleaded with Luffy to stop Yuta because he was her friend. Surprisingly, Beppo was transformed into a small size, and Yuta appeared. Yuta asked Gordon, "Why are you staying with pirates?" Luffy also asked why she left Shanks' crew, but Yuta don't want to talk about Shanks. Yuta tied up Luffy and took his straw hat. She wanted Luffy to stay and play with her, but Luffy still refused. Just as Yuta was about to take action, Law quickly teleported Luffy away. Luffy wanted to go back to retrieve his straw hat, but Law and Barto locked him up. Due to a disease he caught from Zoro, Barto took the wrong path, causing them both to fall down a cliff. They were rolling around, and both ended up vomiting, but luckily, they weren't discovered by the enemy soldiers. They rolled down to the harbor. At this moment, Luffy was in panic because the sunny ship had disappeared. Unexpectedly, a small creature emerged from under the sea, and it turned out to be the sunny ship that Yuta had enchanted. Gordon scolded Yuta for not supporting him. He said he did it out of concern for her and advised her to stop because the Navy and the world government were hunting her. Yuta didn't think much of the Navy and arrogantly stated that she had the upper hand. The old man panicked when he realized that it was Tot Musica. The Navy fleet had also arrived. Although there were no apparent enemies in the vicinity, everyone was asleep. Yuta unexpectedly stepped forward in front of Vice Admiral Momonga. She threatened that if they killed her, everyone here would never recover their souls. Admiral Fujitora stepped forward and claimed he knew about her devil fruit ability. Yuta retorted, "Then there's no need to explain." Yuta started eating a mushroom, which Fujitora recognized as the stay awake mushroom, which prevents the person who eats it from sleeping until they become exhausted and eventually die. The two admirals tried hard to persuade Yuta to stop, but because she was determined, she didn't bother to listen to what they were saying. Yuta started singing, and the Navy immediately used noise-canceling earpieces. Kobe and Hermep rushed down to attack the two admirals. Yuta controlled all of her fans, who swarmed the Navy soldiers. Fujitora realized that everyone was being controlled, so he ordered not to shoot them. By the way, those sunglasses really suit Fujitora, making it impossible to tell that he was blind. These people rushed in to remove the Navy's equipment. Yuta used her mesmerizing singing to control all the Navy forces. At this moment, the Straw Hat Pirates and others were trying to escape from the musical staff, and since Brook was located below Nami, he came very close to seeing Nami's underwear. Suddenly, Robin noticed that they might be arranged according to the musical notes. She asked Brook for help, but Brook said that he was temporarily blind and couldn't see anything, except for Nami's underwear. Surprisingly, Kobe appeared and said, "Read this, old man." Nami was immediately freed, followed by Sanji and the rest. Big Mom's group begged to be rescued, but with the condition that they would cooperate with everyone. On the other side, Tiny Beppo successfully saved Gordon. Meanwhile, Law's group was on the move when Kobe managed to locate them. Luffy begged Kobe to let him out because he might throw up if he stayed there any longer. Law questioned why Cypher Pole and the Navy were here. Kobe explained that he also wanted to know Yuta's power. He revealed that this world was not the real world, it was a world of souls. Everything they saw was Yuta's imagination, and it drew the souls of the listeners into the world of souls. In this world, Yuta has the freedom to create any rules she wants. Luffy now remembers that Yuta mentioned his power, which causes everyone to fall asleep when she sings. If only he had remembered sooner, things would have been easier. Law suggests that devil fruit powers must have their limitations, and Kobe mentions that maintaining this power consumes a lot of energy. It would lose its effectiveness if Yuta were to fall asleep. Therefore, before her performance, Yuta ate the awakening mushroom to stay awake. But if Yuta were to die from exhaustion, the souls of everyone would remain trapped in this world forever. Meanwhile, Robin's group has arrived at the Allegia Castle. After a diplomatic exchange with the mice, Chopper learns about a room filled with books on the other side. Jinbei and Frankie blow the door off with an explosion, and they enter, only to be attacked by stone statues. Zoro uses his Supreme Grade Triple Sword technique, Sanji employs Diable Jam, and the rest of the group starts to fight as well. Robin then notices something unusual on the ceiling. Yuta's song continues to spread, and anyone who listens to her singing loses their soul. In Mary Geo's, the five elders are suffering due to the rapidly increasing number of victims. At this rate, in just an hour, 70% of the world's population will be drawn into the world of music. This event is like a doomsday scenario. Unexpectedly, celestial dragon people appear in Yuta's world. Everyone kneels before them. However, Yuta doesn't care about the celestial dragons because she was told about their cruelty when she was young. Their subordinates attempt to shoot Yuta, but she easily neutralizes their attack. The celestial dragon person kills his own subordinates for their incompetence, and Yuta saves the two people and hangs the rest of the attackers on the musical staff. Yuta gave the ugly celestial dragon a beating, and the audience advised Yuta not to anger the celestial dragons because the marines would hunt her down. Suddenly, a boy wanted to go home, and Yuta couldn't understand why he wanted to return to a difficult life instead of enjoying the happiness here. A gate opened, and Kobe stepped out. He wanted Yuta to release the souls back to the real world. The audience knew Kobe because he had saved everyone in Rockyport. Kobe told everyone that this was not the real world, and they had been deceived. Therefore, it was best to leave as soon as possible. This sparked debates, with some wanting to stay and others wanting to leave. Yuta saw this and used her power to create a sea, turning everyone into teddy bears as it passed over them. Kobe managed to escape and return. The children of Big Mom said, "We'd rather die than cooperate with Luffy's group," so they decided to leave. Robin was trying to quickly decipher Musica's secret, while the others were still fighting the stone statues. They had used various techniques, but it seemed this ancient castle couldn't withstand their attacks. The entire castle began to collapse, and Nami threatened Broly, saying that if she didn't allow them to enter the world inside the mirror, she would be in trouble. Finally, the entire group regrouped, and Robin explained the world of souls. Normal humans couldn't return to the real world. But the person who possessed Tat Musica had a chance. Tat Musica was an entity from ancient times created by the loneliness and sadness of humans, also known as the Demon King. If the Demon King was awakened, it would appear as a connecting thread between the real world and the world of souls. If it was attacked simultaneously in both worlds, it could be defeated. At this moment, the troops appeared, and everyone temporarily hid. Beppo, in his tiny form, led Gordon to the front, saying that only red-haired Shanks in the real world could stop Yuta. Luffy asked Gordon what had happened between Shanks and Yuta, but he didn't answer, so Luffy ran off to ask Yuta. The remaining people began to prepare for the attack. Luffy approached Yuta, and she claimed that he couldn't defeat her. She created puppets, but Luffy easily dealt with them. However, in the end, Luffy didn't fight Yuta. Instead, he angrily punched the water. Yuta asked why Luffy wanted to become the Pirate King, and he said it was to create a new era. Yuta became furious and pushed Luffy away. Having two of her men capture him as if he was being executed, similar to what happened to Gold Roger. Yuta tore Luffy's straw hat, making him even more angry, and he punched the water again. Yuta hated pirates because she believed that Shanks had abandoned her 12 years ago. According to Gordon, Shanks had exploited her singing voice to destroy and steal all the treasure on the island. Yuta was in agony as she ran to the dock, but Shanks' ship had already left with the treasure, and Shanks was now a wanted man for the crimes she had unknowingly committed. Luffy was furious because he believed that Shanks would never do such things. Consumed by hatred, Yuta decided to kill Luffy in the real world. But just as her knife was about to strike, a hand stopped her. It was Shanks, along with his pirate crew. However, Yuta was consumed by hatred, and she cried and laughed, calling on everyone to kill this wicked pirate. Luffy, witnessing the strange behavior of Yuta, also noticed that Shanks had arrived. At this moment, everyone rushed to attack Yuta, but unfortunately, they couldn't harm her. In the real world, those controlled by Yuta had attacked the red-haired pirates. But the red-haired pirates didn't fight back. Unexpectedly, the man attacking Shanks was shot by the Navy. Yuta cried as she watched a stranger die in front of her and the barrage of cannonballs headed toward her. It turns out that Akainu had received orders from the Five Elders to kill Yuta at any cost, so the Navy coldly shot the innocent people. Next, Admiral Kizaru fired a laser at the island where Shanks was standing. He didn't expect Shanks to react so quickly and confront him. Kizaru immediately fled to another location, but Shanks quickly appeared, holding his sword to Kizaru's throat. However, Fujitora disagreed with leaving and stated that it was the responsibility of the Navy. Yuta, having witnessed the Navy's cruelty rivaling that of the pirates, decided to use Top Musica to wipe out everything she deemed wicked. She quickly retrieved the cursed music score and began to sing, causing a surge of dark, malevolent energy in both worlds. The more she sang, the more she descended into madness. The Demon Lord was reborn as a result. Shanks immediately rushed to attack the Demon Lord, but it effortlessly sent the strongest four emperors flying. It continued to unleash red lightning bolts, destroying the entire Navy fleet. In the spirit world, the 500 pirate siblings joined forces to attack the Demon Lord. However, they were still no match for the powerful Demon Lord, and they could only delay it to give Luffy a chance to approach Yuta. Unfortunately, Luffy was struck by Yuta and sent spinning in the air. Yuta then coldly created a sword and threw it at Luffy. Gordon rushed to his aid to protect Luffy from the sword. He did this to prevent Yuta from continuing down the wrong path, but Yuta coldly stated that she would eliminate all the pirates present. Gordon then revealed the truth to Yuta, telling her that the one who devastated Allegia 12 years ago was not Shanks, but the Demon Lord Top Musica. Yuta sang so beautifully that it awakened the Demon Lord. It used its remaining magic to bring the Top Musica music score in front of Yuta, and not knowing what it was, she sang the score. The Demon Lord was released from its seal and took over Yuta's body, slaughtering all the island's inhabitants. Gordon was heartbroken to witness his people's demise, and he begged Yuta to regain her senses. He explained that only the red-haired pirates were strong enough to battle the Demon Lord. Luckily, Yuta was still a child and became exhausted, causing the Demon Lord to disappear as it couldn't possess her anymore. Unfortunately, the kingdom was destroyed, and the Marines had arrived at that moment. Shanks requested that Gordon keep the recent events a secret and claimed that the red-haired pirates had looted Allegia. Shanks wanted Gordon to raise Yuta to become the world's greatest singer because it was the dream of his little daughter. Afterward, the red-haired pirates left with the crimes committed at Allegia. After hearing the whole story, Luffy was overjoyed and rushed to Yuta. Yuta unexpectedly knocked Luffy away once more, but Luffy wasn't angry. He noticed that Yuta still held onto a drawing he had made for her when she was a child. Young Luffy had drawn an image that resembled the Straw Hat but looked more like a mushroom. Luffy explained that it symbolized a new era. At this point, Luffy took Yuta's hand and advised her to stop her actions because she was destroying the world rather than creating a new era. But the Demon Lord still had control over her and attacked everyone. In the real world, Yuta controlled all the citizens, directing them to attack the Marines. Kizaru, who had taken a punch, ended up killing civilians, and Ben intervened to stop him, which confused Kizaru. Ben explained that the red-haired pirates didn't want Yuta to bear additional guilt. Shanks realized that Yuta had consumed the Awakening Mushroom and that defeating the real Demon Lord was the only way to sever the connection between the Demon Lord and Yuta. Yuta's mind was truly immersed in the darkness of the Demon Lord. She admitted that last year, she had picked up a snail that recorded the events when Allegia was destroyed. It was due to her singing that the Demon Lord had awakened. However, many people around the world still wanted to hear her sing, such as a young girl who wished to hear Yuta sing forever. Therefore, Yuta decided to create a new world. Inside the world created by Yuta, the Straw Hat Pirates and Robin were leading the citizens into Brulee's mirror world. The remaining pirates were launching a coordinated attack against the Demon Lord. Luffy also switched to Gear 4 to fight the Demon Lord. Outside the real world, Shanks was also battling the Demon Lord, but all the attacks did not harm the Demon Lord at all. At this point, everyone realized that they had to launch a simultaneous attack in both worlds to have a chance to defeat the Demon Lord. Usopp could now communicate telepathically with his father outside the real world, as he could see what his father saw. He asked everyone to attack the Demon Lord's right leg first. Usopp's father also requested the red-haired pirates to do the same. Very quickly, everyone succeeded in smashing the Demon Lord's right leg. Then came the left leg, left arm, and right arm, and the Demon Lord quickly weakened. Shanks then gathered his strength to unleash his final move, and Luffy used all his power to charge at the Demon Lord. In a fleeting moment, he saw the innocent form of his friend, Yuta, and Shanks recalled the image of his beloved little daughter. It turns out the red-haired pirates had found a treasure chest at sea, and when they opened it, they found a cute two-toned-haired girl. At this point, Shanks and Luffy approached the Demon Lord, and without coordination, they both struck at the same time, landing a furious blow on the Demon Lord. The Demon Lord truly met its end and dissipated. At this point, Yuta was exhausted in Shanks' arms, and she asked why her father had come to rescue her. Shanks responded simply, saying that he couldn't leave his daughter behind. Shanks asked Yuta to take a calming medicine and assured her that a good night's sleep would make her feel better. However, Yuta pushed the medicine away, unable to sleep because the people in the spirit world would be trapped forever. She had to continue singing to bring them back. Shanks understood that if she continued to sing, his daughter would be in danger. Yuta quickly summoned her strength to continue singing. Everyone in the spirit world heard the most beautiful sound in the world and found the doorway to return. After completing her mission, Yuta collapsed in Shanks' arms, apologizing for not trusting him. Shanks, in turn, never blamed his beloved little daughter. At this moment, Kizaru and Fujitora led the navy to apprehend Shanks and take Yuta into custody. Yuta, knowing she was about to die, told Shanks to surrender her. He warned that if they wanted to take his daughter, they would have to kill him first. Shanks released his conqueror's haki, causing the entire navy to pass out. Realizing they couldn't fight Shanks, Kizaru ordered the navy to leave. A moment later, everyone woke up, and the Straw Hat Pirates realized they were on the Sunny. Luffy, in shock, looked at Shanks' departing ship without having the chance to reunite with Yuta and Shanks. Thank you for watching the One Piece Red, and don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell to receive updates when the channel releases new videos.